Ouch. Yeah, so you notice I scattered its composition like right before he was ready to attack. Should have been a lot earlier. Well done. Kaboom. Yeah, having those bangs earlier would have been amazing. Okay, so it's well established as a leak in my play, Overseer Scouting in the mid game. So what I want to do is not just say, all right, I'm going to Overseer Scout when Lair is done. I need to Overseer Scout again when he basically makes his tech choice, because I scouted that he was going Double Forge, which means he's going to be heavy commitment on the ground, but I didn't scout whether it was going to be Stalkers or a Zealot Archon or whatever. If it was Stalkers, my army would have been amazing against it, because I had tons of Lings, and Lings trade really, really well against Stalkers. But against Zealot Archon, you really want to have, like, Roach Bane or something. Lings are pretty bad. Let's look over this game against the surprisingly tall Protoss Pili Pili. So, Pili Pili streams with his knees up in his chair, which makes him look like a small person, like maybe he can't touch the ground with his feet. But I met Pili Pili at BlizzCon, and he's very tall. He's like 6'3", which for those of you not in the country with stupid measurement, is like 190 centimeters at least. So Pili Pili definitely has the edge of how tall he is in this game. I'm only 6 foot, so I'm trying to compensate for that by playing the easiest race in the game, Zerg. So he has a slight worker lead. He did kill a little bit with this Oracle. He did a good job of getting value from the Oracle and keeping it alive. So, like these casts give him vision on my economy size and what units I'm making in this general area. Let's look at his vision. Yeah, so this lights up this area. He knows I have an Overseer. He later scouts that I have a Dropper Lord. He knows I have double Evo. He has double Forge. This is 2-2 upgrades on the way. Yep. He's taking charge. He has gateways. I think scouting this would have been a pretty good tell that he was going for Zealot Archon. If he was going for Stalkers, he would have just had Stalkers here instead of Zealots. So this Overseer, I didn't get to see the Zealots actually. So I think he deliberately moved these Zealots away from the Overseer to conceal the information that he was going Zealot Archon, because that really kind of gives me less information about what composition I should go for if I don't see, like, his main fighting unit, which was the Zealot. Yeah, so he's massing Zealots here. So maybe think about around 7 minutes into the game, when both players have been on three bases for a while, there aren't really any major engagements, like no big fights at the moment. So he's not showing me what his army is by attacking me. He's basically getting value from his three bases, breaking the rocks, he'll take a fourth, and then attack behind the fourth base. So what will be good against this? Couple things. One thing would be having Lurkers in front of my fourth base. I went for melee upgrades, which I think is fine. Lurkers are still pretty good. But here, I have a problem with the main unit in my composition. I have 73 Zerglings. He has 21 Zealots. So the main unit in my army is countered by the main unit in his army. And the second main unit, the Archon. Really the only unit that I'm good against. Wait. I'm not gonna get to any of these units. Yeah, so Infestors being on the way is kind of a nice idea, but having Banelings a lot sooner, like say I scouted at 7 minutes, there were some Zealots here rather than Stalkers. I could have dropped a Bane Nest immediately, or maybe just taken a Bane Nest when I took a Roach Warrant. That would be a nice adjustment. Having Speed Banes would really like bonk the bulk of his army. Like think about this movement here. He has a lot of Zealots that are all clustered up really nicely. I could either do Burrowed Banes here, or just have some Speed Banes here, some Speed Banes here, and maybe some Banes here, and go kind of like a Roach Bane army, and just smash him when he moved up. But he very intelligently kind of concealed his army composition from me so that my composition was just really weak against his, even though we're even on supply. So, well played, Pilly Pilly. Getting information, concealing information, and then going for a counter composition for what I was going for.